Terrific. Oh, man.
So you guys are sexy.
Are we sexy?
It's a morning show.
We're trying.
I mean, I have to say.
We're trying to be sexy.
Well, when I knew you were here, the first thing I said is, she is sexy.
Oh, man. Oh. Look at you.
But you're married, Ty.
That doesn't matter, really. No, kidding. It's a morning show, I know.
This is an interesting thing that I don't think I knew about you, because I always think of you, and I don't know why I think of you this way, but I think of you as a New Yorker, but you're from Burbank, California.
I'm a Valley girl.
You're a Valley girl?
Yes, I am.
I've always heard about Valley girls.
Right? And everything that you heard is probably true.
I think I'm raising a Valley girl.
Really? Of yeah. course you are. I am too.
Yeah. Oh, you are.
You okay, have the you. Accent down.
I try. It's like
good.
All I ever hear. When I go to college, I just want to go to the University of Beverly Hills, 90210.
And what's the big word? It's annoying.
Oh, it's so annoying.
Annoying. That's
and it's
the big word.
Obviously with no B, because it's Avi.
Oh, I don't have Avi. That's good.
Avi. Okay,
that's a new one for me.
But being from Burbank and a Valley girl, how did you end up as an actress? What sparked your interest?
You know, I didn't have an interest in acting. I didn't really know what I was going to do. I'm a high school dropout, which is I'm not proud of, but stay in school, kids. For real. But I went to a Rolling Stones concert in 1972, and a guy was sort of driving his car. He got out of his car. He was with his wife, and he said, "Do you model or act?" I said, "No." So he said, "Well, call my mom." And have your mom call me, and I did. And so he sent me to New York, and so I started modeling. So that was lucky for me.
Yeah, oh, wow. That sounds like the beginning of a very scary movie. But it worked out. So
it actually was scary.
Yeah, knock
I
on
was
wood.
Terrified. Yeah.
I would think that moving to New York at such a young age, during that time,
Absolutely.
Especially, was scary.
Oh, I was scared to death. Yeah. And I was by myself. I took my little cardboard suitcase and went off.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah.
But it worked out for you. Time. And obviously, and over the course of your career, you had a chance to work with like some of the best leading men out there. Have you ever been nervous doing certain scenes with some of these guys? Like Pierce Brosnan, the Thomas Crown Affair.
Okay, so Pierce. Most women come up and say, okay, what was Pierce like? He's so cute. Is
dreamy.
He a good kisser? He's so dreamy. I love him. And yes, he is a good kisser. For all you ladies.
Yeah.
But, you know, so the love scenes are always really hard. Oops. Goodness. So we're starting one, and I was standing there in a heavy bathrobe and a G-string underneath, waiting for Pierce, and the double doors open, and in walks 007 with a beautiful silver tray, two glasses, and a bottle of champagne. So that's who Pierce is.
Just
He's
to, like,
so great.
Just to, like, relax the
just
whole...
Just kind of to relax me. I don't drink because I just fall asleep if I do, so, you know.
You just watched him have a couple of glasses.
Yeah, exactly.
That's good.
Exactly.
Well, I need one of those to relax right now, but that's all right.
Yeah.
We got to take a quick break, and when we come back, Renee is going to tell us what it's like when she didn't see eye to eye with her director husband on the set of Nightcrawler. So stay right there. More Rene Russo when we come back. We are back with Rene Russo, star of the new movie Nightcrawler. Now, you play Nina Romina.
Yeah,
I love the name. And you're a veteran overnight news producer, and you're desperate to keep your job, right? But what do you like most about playing this character?
Well, at first, I really didn't like her. I didn't like Nina at all. And my husband, who is the director and the writer, he gave me the script. I said, it's beautiful. It's so well written, and it's such a beautiful world. But I really don't like Nina, and I think you should just start over with her. And I realized that it wasn't the writing. It was that I didn't like her, and I didn't know how to access her because
you have to play it from her point of view.
Exactly. Right. And I had no reference. And then what seemed obvious, or what should have been obvious, is that she was desperate and lonely and afraid. And so then everything sort of sprung from that once I sort of got that. Wow.
But when you're telling your husband, I love it, but it's not for me. How does he take that? How is it working with your husband on a movie? Because he wrote it, he directed it. Was he always right? Because he is the guy running the show.
No. He is not always right. You know, first of all, I was a little bit more, I think, vulnerable than he'd written it. And then when we were on the set, we were pretty cool until the first day. Well, until the first day. We were good at home.
And we were fine. And then the first day of shooting happened.
Because I thought we'd had it all straightened out at home. And he said, you know, I think that you're a little too sensual with him. And I thought, no, because I'm going to go somewhere with this Danny. And the fact is that she uses that because she probably had to.
Yeah.
You know, in her career, mm-hmm. just kind of use that, you know, with the boys upstairs.
Oh, I always use my sensuality. Right.
But you do, and you don't know it.
I don't even think I have that.
Yes, but no. Naturally do.
We want to see your sensuality. Well, I want to take a look at a clip.
Okay.
Let's take a look at a clip, okay? In this scene, your desperation to stay on top of the ratings comes through, right? And you're having a cameraman, right? And your news footage is coming across, and here you are in Nightcrawler, Rene Russo in Nightcrawler.
We find our viewers are more interested in urban crime, creeping into the suburbs. What that means is a victim, or victims, preferably well-off and white, injured at the hands of the poor or a minority.
Just crime?
No. Accidents play. Cars, buses, trains, planes, fires.
Oh, bloody.
Well, graphic. The best and clearest way that I can phrase it to you, Lou, to capture the spirit of what we air, is think of our newscast as a screaming woman running down the street with her throat cut.
I understand.
There. Everybody, make sure you go see Nightcrawler. It opens in theaters everywhere tomorrow, October 31st, Halloween. So make sure you see Nightcrawler and Rene Russo, everybody.
Valley Girl?
Yes, I am.
I've always heard about Valley Girls.
Right? And everything that you heard is probably true.
I think I'm raising a Valley Girl.
Really? Of course you are. I am too.
Yeah, oh, you are.
Okay, you have the accent down.
I try. It's like all I ever hear. When I go to college, I just want to go to the University of Beverly Hills, 90210.
And what's the big word? It's annoying.
Oh, it's so annoying.
Annoying.
And it's
the big word.
Obviously with no B, because it's Avi.
I don't have Avi. That's good.
Avi. Okay?
Okay, that's a new one for me.
But being from Burbank and a Valley Girl, how did you end up as an actress? What sparked your interest?
You know, I didn't have an interest in acting. I didn't really know what I was going to do. I'm a high school dropout, which is I'm not proud of, but stay in school, kids. For real. But I went to a Rolling Stones concert in 1972, and a guy was sort of driving his car. He got out of his car. He was with his wife, and he said, "Do you model or act?" I said, "No." So he said, "Well, call my mom." And have your mom call me, and I did. And so he sent me to New York, and so I started modeling. So that was lucky for me.
Yeah, oh, wow.
String underneath, waiting for Pierce, and the double doors open, and in walks 007 with a beautiful silver tray, two glasses, and a bottle of champagne. So. That's who Pierce is. He's so great.
Just to like relax the
just kind of to relax me. But I don't drink because I just fall asleep if I do, so you know.
You just watched him have a couple of glasses.
Yeah, exactly.
That's good.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, I need one of those to relax right now, but that's all right.
Yeah.
We gotta take a quick break, and I want to come back. Renee's gonna tell us what it's like when she didn't see eye to eye with her director husband on the set of Nightcrawler. So stay right there, more Rene Russo when we come back. We are back with Rene Russo, star of the new movie Nightcrawler. Now you play Nina Romina. Yeah, I love the name. And you're a veteran overnight news producer, and you're desperate to keep your job, right? But what do you like most about playing this character?
Well, at first, I really didn't like her. I didn't like Nina at all. And my husband, who is the director and the writer, he gave me the script. I said, it's beautiful, it's so well written, and it's such a beautiful world, but I really don't like Nina. And I think you should just start over with her. And I realized that it wasn't the writing.
Because he wrote it, he directed it. Was he always right? Because he is the guy running the show.
No. He is not always right. You know, first of all, I was a little bit more, I think, vulnerable than he'd written it. And then when we were on the set, we were pretty cool until the first day. Well, until the first day. We were good at home.
And then the first day of shooting happened.
Because I thought we'd had it all straightened out at home. And he said, you know, I think that you're a little too sensual with him. And I thought, no, because I'm going to go somewhere with this Danny. And the fact is she uses that because she probably had to.
Yeah.
You know, in her career, mm-hmm. just kind of use that, you know, with the boys upstairs.
Oh, I always use my sensuality. Right.
But you do, and you don't know it.
I don't even think I have that.
Yes, but you naturally do.
We want to see your sensuality. Well, I want to take a look at a clip.
Okay.
Let's take a look at a clip, okay? In this scene, your desperation to stay on top of the ratings comes through, right? And you're having a cameraman, right? And your news footage is coming across, and here you are in Nightcrawler, Rene Russo in Nightcrawler.
We find our viewers are more interested in urban crime, creeping into the suburbs. What that means is a victim, or victims, preferably well-off and white, injured at the hands of the poor or a minority.
Just crime.
No, accidents play, cars.